To the Philippine Benchmark Index now, the PSEI finished today's trading in the green, closing at 66.79. Value turnover was at 5.6 billion pesos. All right, what moved the market today? How's it pricing in? BSP sustained hawkish stance, among others. Jafet Antianco of Fieldstax Financials joins us to weigh in on these issues today. Hi, Jafet.
Hi, Stanley. Thank you for inviting me.
All right, so today we're quite strong at 66.79, more than 5 billion in volume. Also good. Now, we're still not hitting 6,700 though. Now, how strong is the hesitation of this market to hit that level? Because we seem to have built a strong support already in the 6,500, but breaking resistance is still a challenge.
Well, yes, we've been seeing the market rising and heading towards 6,700. But if you're going to look at the value turnover, it remains tepid. If you're going to look at the net value turnover or value turnover less the block sales, you're going to see that for January so far, it's only been averaging about, 4.5 billion pesos per day.
4.5.
It's not even getting 4.5 billion pesos per day. So it's not even getting past 5 billion. So that's tepid value turnover, which reflects, you know, a lack of conviction towards the market's rise this January, which also implies that many people or many investors are still staying on the sidelines. It also goes to show the character. If you're going to look if you're going to look deeper, it goes to show the character of our investors, their sentiment towards the market right now. Some are still risk averse, given the lingering downside risks towards the local economy, primarily our inflation, which still has some upside risk given the threats of El Nino. And then there are some who are who don't see it as an exciting time right now, given that there are still no interest rate cut prospects from the BSP, at least in the short term. Yeah. So moving forward, I believe this is what investors would like to see before we see that strong participation in the market that will drive it or that will make it easier for it to get past 6-7. We need to see, you know, the inflation problem or the inflation risks getting addressed, as well as those rate cut prospects. Till we see those, breaking past the 6-7 resistance, it's possible, but it will be challenging.
Okay. Possible but challenging. Now, I'd like to backtrack a bit to what you mentioned about participation earlier. Of course, we know that some investors, as you've mentioned, are staying on the sidelines. Some are selling and locking in gains from previous rallies. Now, foreign funds, though, are they exiting the market? I mean, has this been noted lately? And how significant are the numbers? And how may this affect prices in the near term?
Well, recently, we've been seeing some net foreign selling. Yesterday, net foreign selling was
about 4 billion, more or less?
Yes, 400 million, above 400 million. Okay. And then on Monday, we saw net foreign selling of above 800 million. But if you're going to look at January so far, if you're going to get the total, the local market is still registering a net foreign inflow of about 3 billion, a little above 3 billion pesos. So on the net, we're still experiencing net foreign inflows, and I believe this is the reason why this is one of the reasons why the local market has been performing well, or has been moving upwards for this January. So on foreign funds, we are still good. However, what I'm worried about right now is the movement of the local currency. Okay. So as if you're going to monitor the peso, again, it's been weakening. It's been moving above 56 per US dollar levels. And the problem with that is if this is sustained, if the weakness of the peso is sustained, then this could be something that could repel or that could discourage foreign investors from getting into the market. So what I'm trying to say is if the weakness of the peso is sustained, then that could be the time that we start to see a build up in net foreign outflows, which will be bad for the local market.
All right, but still, you know, today was a rally, probably influenced by a lot of other factors. In fact, Asian markets seem to be reacting well to China's efforts to stabilize the economy. What positive signs do you see now that indicate a recovery in China's economy? And is this also one of the reasons why we're more or less relatively strong?
Well, with respect to China or China's economy, we're not yet seeing China's economy is growing. However, it's not growing in line with the expectations of investors. And that's where the problem lies. Moving forward, rather than signs of strength, what we're seeing for China's economy is at least signs that the government is still there, willing to support the economy in order for it to, you know, in order for it to grow in line of investors' expectations. You have monetary policies which are still at accommodative levels, and then you have the fiscal policies. You have the government pledging, you know, pledging spending, more spending this 2024 in order to boost the economy. Of course, if by the end of the day, they still need their private sector to you know, to move, to take advantage of those aids that are being given by the government, both the monetary and the fiscal side. But if we are to see that, I mean the policy support is already there. If the private sector will be able to take advantage of that, then of course we're going to see, you know, possibly higher consumption and higher investment spending in China's economy, which in turn will, you know, will boost the overall economy, and this is going to be positive for us.
All right, Japheth, I'd like to talk about the BSP now. A sobering note there, saying it is not in a hurry to pivot from its hawkish stance. Now, I'd like to know what you think about this and what is the market sentiment regarding the possibility of rate cuts not happening anytime soon in the Philippines.
I believe this is something that is already being priced in by the local market, which is also one of the reasons why, as mentioned a while ago, participation is not that high. Investors are expecting that rate cuts may not be happening anytime soon. In fact, for Phil stocks, we are projecting rate cuts to happen only by the second half of this year. And the reason for that is that, as mentioned, we're still facing upside risks to inflation.
Yeah.
Particularly, well, first you have the threats from El Nino, and then...
Japheth, are you still there? All right, we seem to have lost that connection to Philstocks Financials. Japheth Tantiangco was talking to us about Banco Central's possible hawkish stance to persist as inflation threats continue. All right, Japheth, are you back?
Hello. Yeah.
Okay, as you were saying.
Yeah, so as I was saying a while ago, we are still seeing these upside risks to inflation. These upside risks to inflation, and these in turn, you know, if left unchecked, could de-anchor inflation expectations. So because of that, it is expected that, you know, at least for the first half of the year, the BSP will keep policy rates unchanged. And I think this is what, again, this is what investors are pricing in. That's why we are not really seeing that much participation in the market.
Okay, lastly, and perhaps very briefly, you know, it's been fast. We're ending January already next week. So what's your trading guidance for the coming months?
Okay, so for the local market, statistically speaking, for the past 10 years, January has been a gaining year. January has been a gaining month for the local market. On average, we've been gaining 1.20% every January. If you're going to look at February, statistically speaking, in the past 10 years, it's been a losing month. It goes down like 0.78% on average. Okay. So our advice is, of course, if you are able to position ahead of January, if you're able to position in December 2023, then by the end of January, it might be good to, you know, lock in some gains.
Right.
Lock in some gains, and as we've been seeing, the market has been rallying, so there's the possibility of a pullback. So lock in some gains, wait for the market to pull back, and once it settles at, you know, strong support levels, right now the immediate support that we're seeing is its 10-day exponential moving average, and then next to that is the 6,400 level. So if one of these will be able to hold the market as it pulls back, then that's going to be a good time to get into the market again.
All right, Jacket Antianco, again, we thank you for talking to us about markets today. Have a good day.
Have a good day as well.